So this will be a quick video about how to do the hinge effect in After Effects. And so let's go ahead and so this is what we'll be creating, and let's go ahead and make a new composition. So composition, new composition. It's going to be 1920 by 1080, 24 frames per second, and we're going to do 2 seconds long. And we're going to go ahead and start off with a solid background, Command Y, and we'll just copy what we did before and make it orange. I'll use my text tool to create the text. And then I'll go ahead and just scale that up to look the way I want it to. And I'll use my align tools to align it vertically and horizontally. Now for the hinge effect to work, we actually have to activate 3D layers. And so we'll go ahead and turn this hinge into a 3D layer by clicking this button right here. And what that does is it gives us an extra dimension, and you can see the gizmo changes its appearance so that we can see all three axes showing up. And so basically it's going to, now if we hit R to show our rotation, you'll see that there is this additional rotation, right? So instead of just one rotation axis, we get all three rotation axes showing up when we activate that. And what we're going to be doing in this video is animating the Y. So put that back at zero. But one thing we have to do first is just reposition our axis point. And so to do that, I'm just going to go up here and click the Pan Behind tool. And then I'm going to use the control points to just scooch it over until it lines up right with the outside edge of that H. And now, when I select my rotation, it's going to rotate right on that edge. Now, in order to get the closing rotation, there are a couple ways we could do that, but what I decided to do is use a parent of a null object. And so I'm going to go up here and say new null. And I'm going to make that null object also a 3D layer. And what I'm going to do here is just align that axis center to the outside edge of my E. And then I will parent the hinge type to the null object that I just created by dragging the pick whip over and selecting my null. And so now you can see parent link is selected to the null object. If you're not seeing these options, to check these little buttons down here at the bottom. So they each expand different levels of control. Okay, so let's go ahead and do our animation. So I'm going to go into about the time when I want to have my hinge in full effect. So it's already done its hinge effect. And I'll go ahead and animate it backwards from there. So I'll give it a keyframe in the Y. And I'm going to have this swing from behind and come towards us. And so we need to think about the swinging of a door, right? So it comes, it's going to go, we'll make it a tight hinge so it's like just a couple times. And so let's go ahead and have that forward motion happen, or that backward motion happen. It's going to go back a little, just a tiny bit, maybe a few frames more over. We'll do our forward motion, so it's swinging all the way up a little bit longer, and then all the way back here we'll go ahead and put it back, and we're just going to rotate it around until it basically disappears because it's in line with the it's perpendicular to the viewing plane right now to our camera. Now it's important to note, because we have our camera in a perspective angle, it's not a parallel view, it's a perspective view, so this dimension is going to change depending on where left, right, top, bottom your object is located. But right now you can see we've got that hinge effect basically functioning, but it just needs to have a little bit more finesse. So we're going to add our easy ease keyframes, function F9, or right click, keyframe assistant, easy ease. And so I like the way that's looking. One thing I don't like is that even though it's completely perpendicular, I still, it's as close as I can get without tweaking it really sort of at ridiculous levels. So what I like to do is just use an opacity change. So I'm just going to go ahead and select my hinge, hit T on the keyboard for opacity, keyframe it at 100% right here, and then go one frame back and keyframe it at zero. And that way what happens is we don't see anything coming on the screen at all until it appears, right? So we won't see any of this hinge coming on the screen until we want it to be there. So let's go ahead and do the exit hinge, and that's going to be pretty simple. Because we have this already parented, we can simply click on our null object and hit R for rotation. We can just go ahead and keyframe the Y rotation where it is, and then go to the point where we want it to leave the screen. And let's have this one go forward, so we'll have it hinge towards us. And I just want to go again till it's as perpendicular to the plane as I can get it. And then we'll go ahead and use our opacity trick again. And we're going to do that on the hinge itself, right? Because a null object doesn't have any appearance. So changing the opacity of that null object wouldn't do anything. So we need to make sure we're changing the opacity of the hinge. So I'm just going to go scroll down and back up to 100, go one frame forward, and then go down to zero. Zero. And that is about it. So now we have our hinge effect functioning. I guess the last thing we should do is put on our easy ease again, just so it's nice and smooth. And there we go. Hinge in and hinge out on the other side. So thanks for watching.